Welcome to Python with Andrew. And in the last few videos, we've been looking at input and output using files. And so far, we've read data in as text. We've also read CSV into a list, and we've read a CSV into a dictionary. So we've tried all sorts of ways of reading data in so that we can use it. And it's worked. I want to continue that process and look at another set of functions that allow us to easily read in files, both CSV files, but also Excel files, which are a bit more understandable for data entry, et cetera. But I'm going to use the Pandas module, and I'll introduce that a bit. I'm not going to spend too much time on that module, but I'll introduce it a bit because I think the data structure that it reads in is actually quite nice and quite useful. So let's zip on over to so this is the code I had before, and we had read the inventory into a text file, into text, read it a CSV file, a dictionary, etc. And if I ran this, you'll see that we had all sorts of data structures that came out. And those data structures are useful, but they're not intuitive and not as easy as we would think. Wouldn't it be nice if we could have a data structure that looked more like the file we read in? And if you remember that, so if I close this down, the file we read in looked more like this as a CSV file. or if I go to the Excel version of this, let's see if I can find the Excel version of this. Looking more like that, where we have columns and we have rows of data. And in the first column, we've got, if you like, the item, and this is a stock. This is our inventory example that I'm using, basic inventory. So it'd be nice if we were able to use this sort of format, because that way, if someone was updating the inventory, they could do it via Excel. And equally, the program could update inventory as it goes along. So let's see what we can do. So I'm going to jump over to a new file. And I'm going to import the Pandas module. Now, Pandas is one of the most used modules in Python, especially for data science, or especially for when we are reading in data in a more tabular form or tabled format. Now, I'm not going to spend too much time in Pandas. It is very complex and lots of functions that allow you to do lots of things. I'm not going to cover that. I simply want to use one or two functions to read my data in into a data structure that I can easily use. All right. And the good thing about Pandas is it makes reading is even easier. So the first thing I can do is I'm going to put it into data, and I'm going to do pandas.read CSV, and this is going to take a file name. read.csv. All right, simple as that. There's no opening the file, closing the file. Pandas does all that for you. And I can print the data just so we can see what it looks like. And you'll see that this one, if it runs correctly, looks a bit nicer. It's a bit right justified, but it looks a bit nicer. And if you like, more like what we read it in before. And we can even go further and access things a bit easier. But to do that, we're going to make the file, the data structure, a bit nicer. And we can do that by, first of all, saying we don't need this column here, 0, 1, 2, 3. We're going to use the item column as our index. So we're going to do index column equals item. Now, if I save that, all that's going to do is going to forget about this 0, 1, 2, 3, because we want to reference things by the item. So now if I run this, I'll clean this up and I run this, you can see that it's a bit nicer. I've got hammer, nuts and bolts, etc., etc. So that's even easier. The other thing is, if I want to access an element, I can now use that column name. So if I wanted to access the stock column, okay, I can just use it like that, which is a bit easier for me to do. So let's see what happens when I do that. Well, it's actually given me both the item and the stock. But if I now wanted to actually, because that's a whole series of items there, but if I wanted to access the stock of the screws, right, I can access it quite easy by saying screws. I can use that particular data there, and it gives me 10, which is the stock of the screws. So that makes it a lot easier, because now I can get at individual elements quite easily using the column I want and the row. So it's column first and then row second. Sometimes when we do Excel, we do row first and then column, but in Pandas, we do column first and then row. Now, there are other ways of accessing individual elements in Pandas. I'm going to put that to another day. This will do because it's nice and easy to understand. So if I wanted to update the data, equals 50. All right. Let me do plus equals 50. But let's assume we just got some more stock in. And now if I print the data out afterwards, you can see, no surprise, that it should be updated. You can go see it's gone from 10 to 60. So that's an easy way for me to say, okay, what item do you want to update? It's screws. And then how do we want to update it? So far, so good. And you can see another interesting thing that we notice is I did plus equals 50. So I use that as a numeric. And if you remember back to the earlier videos, I was bringing in that column as strings. Pandas is smart enough to say, these are all numbers, so I'm going to bring them in as numbers, right? So that's very useful. If it doesn't do exactly what we want, we can actually add another part to here and converters equals stock int. So we could actually right there saying, while you're reading it in, also convert this column to integers, which is quite nice and useful. Okay. It did it for us, but if we had something long and it didn't quite convert the way we wanted to, we can do that converting there. We can also do something a bit nice and easy. We could actually, as we're bringing it in, we could change all these ones here to lowercase to make it easier for us to look up, because maybe if someone types things in, we want to make sure that it's all in lowercase. But we'll worry about that another time. So that's reading a CSV file. Now, no surprise, if we were using Pandas for reading in an Excel file, all I've got to do is change the function I use, read Excel, and I want to read not the CSV file, but I've got an Excel file there called XLSX. That's the Excel format that I've got. I'm going to keep all the same information there, and I'm going to print the data afterwards. Okay. And let me clear that. So we're going to bring in the CSV. I've still got my junk printing here. And then we're going to bring it in again, but this time as Excel. All right. And I think that's quite nice because we have changed our functions into one line. We could have kept it quite simple, but I added a column identifier so I can easily access things. I also converted it. It wasn't necessary in this case, but I did that anyway. And no surprise, there is also a write function. Right? So you can guess what the write function is before we try it out. You're able to work out what the way of writing the Excel file is. Well, it's, again, we're just using a method in Pandas. So in this case, so let me clean everything up first. Let's just focus on Excel. Okay, and I'm going to read the Excel file. I'm going to print the data out. In fact, I'm going to change the data. So I'm going to do data stock. Screws plus equals 50. So we're going to add 50 to the stock and screws. And then I want to write it out. I'm going to write it out to the same file. Let's see how that works. Now to do that, I just use data.toExcel and I specify the file name, which in this case is that one there. Okay. So with any luck, I'm reading the Excel file in. I'll print it out just so we can see what the file's like. And then I'm going to update the inventory. That, of course, that could be much, much more complex work. And then I'm going to write it out. Let's see what happens. So first time through, it printed that out. It's fine. We don't know if the file was updated, though. We can't see yet. But the way we're going to tell is I'm going to run it again, and this time our screws should be not 10, but should be 60. So let's run it again. And as you can see, screws are 60. And if I run it again, now screws are 110. So it's continually updating our inventory and then writing it back out. So this is actually a really nice, simple way of adding more and more data to our inventory, using it, changing it, etc. So a nicer data structure for us to use, but also something that's a bit more readable, and it's actually a bit easier to use. So that's using the Pandas module. Now, as I mentioned, Pandas is much, much more extensive. We'll leave that for another day. What we've done now is we've looked at how we can read text files, CSV files, Excel files. We can bring them in as a list. We can bring them in as a dictionary. We can bring them in as a table, or in Pandas terminology, it's called a data frame. I look at it and just say it's a table, but the technical term is data frame. So we've got different ways of reading, different file types, different ways of bringing it in and then manipulating the information. Well, which is really, really useful. We'll continue on because there's a few other ways that we can bring data in that we can use for different purposes. One that I like is using JSON, which is a way of bringing in a dictionary data structure, which we could use for configuration information. Let's say players in a game or things like that. So we'll touch on that next. And then, of course, we'll lead up towards having our inventory in a database. Because the one problem about this inventory is if I'm running my program and I'm changing the inventory, only I can change the inventory because I've got a copy in my system. Whereas if someone else was someone next door, etc., they couldn't update the inventory. So this methodology is single user. When we link into a database, we're going to use the power of a relational database or any database to make it multi-user and a bit easier for us to have multiple programs running at the same time. And it's very easy to do. But we'll worry about that another day when we talk about databases. So I hope that's been useful. Experiment with the different methods. Remember to pick the method that suits your program the best. because different methods will be used in different cases. I like this method at the moment, but if I had a different application, I might choose a different method. And we will. Until we talk again, thanks very much for watching. Do subscribe if you're enjoying this, and do share these videos to friends to help them learn Python as well. Thanks a lot. Have a great day.